Yeah, I'd like to talk a little bit about the open day on E for Hale. I developed this one to Uni Open. I was working on user interface customization, and when you're working on user customization and want to change the layout of running application, that you're running into the problem that at each stage the layout should be a consistent state. For example, there are two main issues. For example, there are the controls can be overlapping, and that should be avoided. And for example, if you move an item to another position, then sometimes happens that this overlap can occur. And one problem I was targeting with this editor was that that I can make sure that there's no overlap or time, and not also at the current size of the window, but also if I resize the window, that the layout still stays overlap free. But I will show an example later. But first, a small introduction into GUI layout management. In the beginning, in earlier GUI toolkits, I had to position all the views at a fixed position and a fixed size. It was the same with the V API. That's the problem is if I'm designing an API, then sometimes I want to reposition items, and that requires that I move existing item to good position, and that makes very cumbersome. And also, if I want to resize them, they're all just very difficult. But there are some GUI layout classes that makes it much easier. With this layout class, I put just some widgets or views into their layout model, and I automatically can display this layout at different layout sizes. This has also the advantage that layouts in the layout model are most of the time easier to align them, or there's the same spacing between the widgets. Margins have the same sizes. It makes it also very easy to support different font sizes, or for example, to support different languages. For example, here it's a Haiku screenshot. The mouse preference window was in English, and on the bottom, I think it's Japanese, I'm not sure anymore. But it requires much more space, and that's easily handled by the layout system. There are different layout models. For example, the border layouts and the layout spaces split into, I think, 8 regions, left, top, right, bottom, and center, or 5. And then there's a group layout, a horizontal or vertical group layout. It's also known as a box layout. Haiku is a group layout. Then there's also the most common layout model is a grid deck layout. Haiku is the grid layout. There's also flow layouts. For example, if, it's like text, and if the width of the layout gets too small, then it wraps into multiple lines. And there's also constraint-based layouts, like for example, the DLM layout class. Yeah, most of the current toolkits, Qt, Qt, Java, Windows, Apple, everybody basically supports most of the classes. At least the grid-backed layout, and probably also group layout. So that's a pretty common technique at the moment. I just want to, who does not know the grid pack layout, just a small introduction. For example, I have this simple layout. In the grid pack layout model, I have rows and columns. For example, I have four rows and two columns. Then I have to specify four values. That is the row and column position and the row and column span. For example, if I want to specify this progress bar, then I put it into row 4, column 1. It has a row span of 1 and a column span of 2. And then this way I can actually quite easy to specify the layout. Then in contrast, the constraint-based layout model, then it works actually quite similar. It's looks basically the same, but no, I don't name the rows and columns, but I name the lines of this grid temp stocks. I have horizontal and vertical temp stocks, and then if I want to specify this progress bar, I can connect it to the left layer border, to the top, to this Y3 horizontal tab, then to the right layout border, to the bottom layout border. One advantage is that I can add some more linear constraints to the layout system. For example, I can could say that that this progress bar, the height, I can just assign it a fixed height, or I can specify size ratios of the widgets, so that makes it quite powerful. And also I can create relations between views which are not directly neighbors in the layout. For example, I could say that this button should be, the width of this button should be a factor of this height of this progress bar. So this makes it quite powerful, but yeah, but for most layout layouts, it's already after a grid back layout, but sometimes for some layouts it's only possible to create some layouts only with grid back constraint based layout. For example, this is one example which is not possible with a simple grid back layout. On the left, this is the layout. I have three rows, and then I resize the layout, and then all three rows resize independent from each other. So on the left, this progress bar is here on the, in the middle of the white button, and if I resize this window, then the left of the progress bar is in the area of this left button. So these two lines are not coupled. And in a grid back layout, I have to put it in a fixed grid, and then I can't change. It always has to be the same side of the grid. For example, the grid would be here, this one and this one, and then the order of the grid lines has to stay fixed in the grid back layout. The constraint-based layout is quite powerful, but there are just a few layout editors. Editor for to create and with backyard, one of the editors in Xcode. They quite recently added some features to create with constraint-based layouts. There's also for Eclipse, Window Builder supports constraint-based layout. The reason why I added or also implemented a new constraint-based layout editor is that all those editors that does not support this overlap feature. For example, I can show that later. So now I just want to present the editor. for example, it's like he does this this window, this canvas window, and I have some widgets on this side, and now I can just drag and drop it into this window and drop it there. I can move it. It always shows where it's possible to drop the widgets. For example, I can also just put it on the right side of the window, but I also can, it directly snaps to the tab stops. For example, now it snaps nowhere and then it takes the big space and just drop it here. I can do something like this. I can also swap items like this, or I can insert items to team other items, and I also can resize items. For example, I can resize this list view to the left of the right button. I also can remove buttons again. Basically move them freely around, but I still but it's not completely a free placement approach. But I can also only can position them to the existing tab stops. That makes it a little bit different to, for example, the Xcode approach, where I just position items freely and then add the constraints between the widgets. And in this approach, I don't really take a look at the constraints, but I just put everything together and create the layout in this way. Then, this is actually quite really basic, so, and features like setting the label of the checkbox is not supported. The only thing which is important at the moment is, for example, that I can give this a different identifier. I can call this checkbox test or something. And I can do this basically for all the buttons here. And with this identifier later, I can access these buttons in my program. Yeah, the only feature which is supported in this editor to change the properties of the widgets is the preferred size. For example, I can change the preferred width of the white item, and this way I can tune a little bit the layout.